Hi there, I'm your agent Lee, and today I have another fabulous Neil Gaiman book for you. It's about a little boy who was born and raised on a graveyard by ghosts. Who comes up with such a great idea? And he has a lovely soul, he has such a great character, and whilst reading the book you get to know all the ghosts on the graveyard, a bit of their background and their stories. There's also a little bit of love, a lot of dangers, and it's great. It's total adventure. It's called The Graveyard Book by Neil Gaiman. And it's also included with some arty drawings, really stunning, with a lot of little details and really black and white. And it gives it a total different soul and total different aspect also, because you also get, you don't just read it and have your own images, which is great, this is why we read books, because we love this sort of thing, but you also have a little bit of art included. Couldn't get any better, can it? So I'm gonna tell you more details what it's about, and I'm also gonna read one, two, maybe three pages to you. So stick with me and listen. In this ingenious and captivating reimagining of Rudyard Kipling's classic adventure, The Jungle Book, Neil Gaiman tells the unforgettable story of Nobody Owens, a living, breathing boy whose home is a graveyard raised by a guardian who belongs neither to the mortal world nor the realm of the dead. Among the mausoleums and headstones of his home, Bod experiences things most mortals can hardly imagine, but real flesh and blood danger waits just outside the cemetery walls. The man who murdered the infant Bod's family will not rest until he finds Nobody Owens and finishes the job he began many years ago. A number one New York bestseller, a winner of many international awards, including the Hugo Award for Best Novel and the Locus Award, The Graveyard Book is a glorious meditation on love, loss, survival, and sacrifice, and what it means to truly be alive. So, like I promised, I'll read you one, two, three pages. Now you're lucky, you even get to see one drawing. How Nobody Came to the Graveyard. There was a hand in the darkness, and it held a knife. The knife had a handle of polished black bone and a blade finer and sharper than any razor. If it sliced you, you might not even know you had been cut, not immediately. The knife had done almost everything it was brought to that house to do, and both the blade and the handle were wet. The street door was still open, just a little, where the knife and the man who held it slipped in, and wisps of nighttime mist slithered entwined into the house through the open door. The man Jack paused on the landing. With his left hand, he pulled a large white handkerchief from the pocket of his black coat, and with it he wiped off the knife and his gloved right hand which had been holding it. Then he put the handkerchief away. The hunt was almost over. He had left the woman in her bed, the man on the bedroom floor, the older child in her brightly colored bedroom, surrounded by toys and half-finished models. that only left the little one, a baby, barely a toddler, to take care of. One more and his task would be done. Did I get you interested in it? I have to admit, I read it 2 times. This is how much I loved it. And every time you read it, you kind of discover new details that you weren't really aware of before. So give it a look. Neil Gaiman is the man of this 100th year. He's incredible. I think you should try one of his books. I have this one. Then we have American Gods, also from Neil Gaiman. Then we have Neverwhere, which I made a little video for you about. Alright. Then we have Anansi Boys, which is also incredibly fascinating. The Ocean at the End of the Lane, one of the more recent ones. Then we have the fabulous and known Stardust. Maybe I should stop saying fabulous, but he makes me say fabulous every 2 seconds. Then we have Coraline. And last but not least, Smoke and Mirrors. So, wish you a good time reading Neil Gaiman.